Hey guys, my name is Dave, and welcome to another video. Sorry, I'm still feeling pretty under the weather. This might go for a while, so there's a lot of coughing in between. I apologize ahead of time. I've actually been making sure I've been taking care of myself as much as I can during this time space. But that's aside from what I was going to talk about this episode. There's not anything particularly. I just wanted to kind of speak my mind today about some stuff. So I don't know. Maybe at some point I'll create a playlist. Dave speaks his mind. Bear in mind, because of this factor, me speaking my mind, there could be some risk to maybe some people not liking some of the things I talk about on this. So I apologize ahead of time. I'm going to try to make my wording as unoffensive as possible, like I always do. So I don't know if there's anything I say, and I know people like who watch this platform, there are some of you like jokingly saying, "Oh, this offended me." In text, please don't do that, because I actually might read it and think, "Oh, okay, I'll avoid that." So yeah, if you're gonna say it, please be serious about it. Don't. And if you're gonna say it jokingly, if you do put it, at least put like a little hint or something ahead of time or afterwards saying, "Hey, yeah, this is just a joke, I'm just messing around," or something like that. But I digress. Welcome to the first official episode of Dave Speaks His Mind. With that being said, so there's been quite a bit going on recently as far as like personal life, the channel, and actually side business partnership kind of things go. Admittedly, granted, the channel doesn't get paid for anything yet, but on the side, I've actually been talking with Aaron about a partnership with a business that he's been putting up, or he's been planning and putting together at the moment. showcase of the website will be actually very soon. We're going to look at it more as a personal thing, not like at their request or anything, but the business that he and a couple friends of his are running. They were discussing with me about and considering doing like a sponsorship type of thing, which may happen. It's most likely going to happen. It'll be the channel's first sponsor, but it'll also be more of a partnership at the same time. And who knows? I'm actually in the process of learning how to animate through Adobe, so maybe we'll get to a point where I could probably help them with some like an animated or a filmed commercial or something. I'll keep you guys posted on that. It's kind of a side thing for the time being, though. Something under discussion, and I've already discussed with them. They think it is a good idea to do this sponsorship thing. It's probably going to be something scripted, though, for their sake. So there will probably be like one video where it's like scripted presentation kind of thing for their website itself. But then on the side, I'll probably do some other alternative videos where I'm discussing it more on a personal matter of my own personal truth to honest sponsor or not opinion kind of thing for it. I've been doing that in person for Aaron, and so far it's been beneficial, because when I do this kind of thing, I'm more the kind of person who will put together constructive criticism in a way that benefits. There are a lot of people out there who look at constructive criticism and go, "Oh, that's what this is." In fact, I've talked about that on this channel, where people talk about constructive criticism and people take it different ways. For me, constructive criticism will come off as the idea of, "Hey, I like this, 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 this. Maybe you should do this to add this to benefit this, because this will happen." That's more my version of constructive criticism. I know, there's a lot of words to this, obviously, I don't say that, but you get what I mean. Now, that's one thing that's been going on recently. As far as the channel itself goes, I've been getting a lot of, hey, play Elden Ring recently. Don't worry. And I say this in a later video today, too. I will get to it. I was going to finish the Dark Souls trilogy first. 1, 2, and 3. DLC, I'll try to include in 2 and 3. I knew I could do it with 1, but I've never really beaten 2 and 3 with the DLC. I've always beaten them without it. But we'll see. I'll try, but I can't guarantee anything. As far as otherwise, like on the business front of the channel goes, we are so close. We're getting so close to being able to get monetized on this channel. And as I'm watching, like keeping an eye on like the numbers and the analytics, more gratitude actually pours over me the further in we go. It's not because of the whole monetization thing. I started this channel, as of this recording, 8 years ago, with the intent to just uplift myself. That's it. And, I mean, given due time, I became fond of the channel, and I made it a consecutive thing to be able to just create content. Now, granted, a lot of the content that was originally on here is gone. For example, a Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild series, or there was another live series I did where it was a bunch of skits that kind of flopped a lot of the time, but some of them are humorous to me. Those are gone. Even if you check the Wayback, there's only, I've looked at the Wayback, and there's only like one reference to the channel, and that was long after even that was removed. So a lot of the original content from this channel, gone. In fact, the only skit that's still on here from the beginning is Facts with Francis video, which I don't know, I've got mixed feelings about. I'm not going to remove it because it's the OG video of the channel, but I've still got a few mixed feelings about it. But where the channel is actually heading, honestly, thanks to all of you guys, it's heading in a direction that's going to benefit in so many different ways. It'll benefit me as a creator, as far as like motivation goes, just seeing the numbers rise. Not to mention, maybe in the long haul it'll financially do so as well, I don't know yet. If it doesn't, it'll definitely mentally benefit me. That's for sure. If for different reasons that I'm not going to get into today, maybe, we'll see. But I will at least put in this detail that a lot of my life has been a lot of turn down. And I'm not talking about like relationships or anything. I'm talking about specifically business opportunity kind of things. For example, there was a point where I actually was going to school to study psychology and sociology and stuff like that. And at a point, my neurologist, I'm not going to say the exact wording, but what they were saying kind of led me to believe that it was just it wasn't worth continuing the schooling after the classes I was taking. So I did what I could. I think one of them I dropped out of. I can't remember. It's possible I did, but I don't know. If I did, I went in deep enough to where I learned a lot anyway. And I keep learning. But it kind of made it a, that statement made it a point that if I had to go to school for it, it probably wasn't going to benefit me as a, like, as a person in the long run because of, like, certain neurological circumstances. So I guess that's one of the things that led me to aim to be an entertainer, kind of in general. Or at least someone who works on content, like on here. I can go into more depth about this later, but I figured I'd at least add that one detail. Yeah, but as far as channel progress goes, honestly, the amount of support the channel's been getting, the amount of comments I've seen recently, I'm trying to keep up with them. Like, let's see if I can pull up some that you guys won't see them, but I'll just read them off because I don't have like a, these vlogs don't get edited like this, the gaming ones do. I don't know. If you guys would like me to start doing a read, reading your comments instead of responding via text all the time, let me know. I'd be more than willing to do that if it's desired enough. Let's see if I can find that. There it is. Okay. So I guess one of the comments, I'm going to go off of the more shorter comments. One thing that kind of, like, the kind of comments that I like seeing, and I've been getting stuff like this a lot recently. User UmbraTrickster7774, when I uploaded tedious pages, the episode Tedious Pages of Slender: The Arrival, the comment they put was, "Have to say, I haven't seen any Slenderman content in many years, that it actually took me by surprise to see this on my recommended." I guess, okay, so it's after saying recommended, it skipped to the words "great video." I think they meant to put recommend, you meant to put recommendations, but yeah, I mean, I think my response was, yeah, welcome. I responded with "welcome aboard the nostalgia train and thank you for the compliment," with like a smiling emoji. Comments like that, the reason I respond like that is just because of the fact that comments like that are the reason I'm so willing to do stuff on this channel. And I mean, like, there are some people, there have been recently, it's been a while since I've gotten recommendations, but recently I've been getting a lot more than I ever expected I would be getting. I could give more examples. A lot of, like, another example, which was on the one of the updates I made on, like, the vlogs. I think I was talking about, like, how I may stop doing the vlogs, and just, I don't know. The 7 days prior to the recording this video, a week prior to the recording this video, so by the time you guys see this, it'll be about 2 weeks ago. 1 week and 5 days, to be more exact. 6 days. 1 week. 1 week and 6 days. I'm gonna try to pronounce this, but I may pronounce it wrong. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm just going to spell it out. WANG Wangishilat Ishalately? Wangishalately? I think. I'm sorry. WANGESHILATELY 1649. I may have said that wrong, so I apologize. In response to that video, they commented "keep going" with like one of those things you see at parties, the emoji that has like a cel it's like a celebration emoji, I believe. I saw that, I was like, okay, I'll see what I can figure out. And sure, a lot of them's probably going to be stuff like, a lot of the vlogs are probably going to end up being stuff like this. One where it's like me just kind of speaking my mind about things going on. But if I can figure anything else out, I'll do it. I'm not going to stop either. There have been a lot of tosses and turns in my personal life, and I'm not going to talk about a lot of them. Especially recently, since a lot of things have uplifted. Things I've come to terms with some stuff. I've progressed in my personal life as well as my business life goes with like stuff like this channel and like I said, the errands of my partnership potentially or sponsorship I should say. nothing solidified yet, but we're getting there. But as far as like personal life goes, I think the progression is getting about to the same speed. Admittedly, over the course of the past month, I've been feeling down a lot of the time, and a lot of the smiles on here are genuine, but they're also kind of partially a farce. I don't like doing that, but I don't like not having content on here. And I guess the gaming stuff on here has helped. me like temporarily get a smile on my face at times, unless it's like a genuine first-hand reaction. In which case, I don't have to do that. But the ones that do need it, I've found ways to work around it. But I think I've gotten to a point where it's like anything that could be considered negative, I've come to accept it, and I've come to terms on my own with that kind of stuff. When it comes to like any, I'm not going to go into detail about personal life stuff. Anything that I needed to talk about that I wanted to share with you guys has been put out there already. For example, the whole I guess a while ago, a couple months ago, I announced to you guys that me and Pink Fox had divorced. At this point, I've come to terms with it. It doesn't bother me. It did for a while, admittedly, just because of some details that I'm not going to get into. I feel like they need to stay personal. I'm not going to talk about it. I also told you guys that it was a cumulative decision, but it still hit me hard in a very negative way just because of. I knew there was still a bond there between her and I, and there still is. Admittedly, not a lot of people agree with that factor, but the fact of the matter is, on a psychological front, it's just because most of the time, this is not the outcome. And a lot of the time, people expect you to stay distant. Don't talk. Keep it separated. And I get that. But I don't know. I will admit, I would frequently still talk with Pink Fox, but she has her life now and I have mine. And there may come a point where we'll just officially stop talking, or maybe there won't. Honestly, I don't know. She has a plan for her future, and I have a plan for mine. They're separate paths, but who knows what'll happen. But yeah, I don't know. Outside of that factor, I'm pretty much gonna keep all the other details about it. Just, I'm not gonna talk about it. This is the kind of thing where I personally would feel like a lot of this needs to just stay with between me and whoever is involved in these personal matters, just me and those people or that person. But that's it. I don't mean to keep secrets or anything, but I just feel like some things just don't need to be talked about. This is my personal opinion on the matter, and I'm sure a lot of people don't agree with me on this. If they don't, that's fine. I can get it. I have a lot, and this is kind of another thing that comes to my mind a lot, that this is still me speaking my mind, and this is something that just comes to my mind a lot on this factor. There are a lot of people who think differently than I do. Almost everyone on the planet does. I guarantee that. Morals are another thing. I've talked about on this channel where my morals lie, where my mindset sits, how I feel about certain things, how I respond to certain things, like work ethics and relationship morals, the consistency, how I feel about that, stuff like that. Personal hygiene, I think, is one I still need to talk about, but a lot of these things, I differ on my own opinions. A lot of people don't share the same opinion I do on this front. I'm sure there's probably a small handful of people who do, but I'm starting to notice that a lot of things I have a personal opinion about, a lot of other people don't agree with. They'll still accept it, but they don't agree with it. Which is kind of the same in contrast. I think that's the term I want to use there. I don't know. But a prime example of this is that for me, I don't know. I'm going to use a past relationship example. Something that's long past, by the way. I believe it was my second or third relationship, one that wasn't really as notable as some others that I keep in mind for future reference. There's only the one detail. I can't even remember off the top of my head who it was. I could think of one. I could think two potential options, but I highly doubt it. I don't know which one it was. But whoever it was, this particular individual, for me, the person went off and found other people instantly when they were planning on breaking up with me. And this happened long before they even broke up with me. Yeah, cheating, basically, I know. As for me, like, a lot of people disagree with this factor. I know that for a fact. I've met enough people and helped enough people relationship-wise, like, just to help them push through things to the point where I get it. A lot of people don't agree with me on this front. But for me, if there's any kind of bond there at all, I patiently wait out until there's a feel for an acceptable opening. Like, for example, that relationship I'm talking about. This obviously now ex-girlfriend, distant ex-girlfriend, found someone instantly. I was like, we're still together. I get it. You want to break up. Why not talk to me about it first? I was irritated, sure, but I wasn't frustrated because at least they admitted their fault. But they still wanted to move on. They wanted to change it to open. I was like, you know, if you're just uncomfortable with being with me, why not break up with me instead of asking for an open relationship? Personally, I don't agree with the idea of open relationships. I think it's a stupid idea. That's just because most of the time the outcome isn't good. A lot of the time the outcome doesn't end well. Open relationships never end well, with the rare exception. And so, if I were given the option of an open relationship, I'd rather just break up. Even after a breakup, I still wouldn't find someone else yet. I'd wait my time. Let's go with the term fate. I'd let fate decide when I needed to be in a relationship next, and where that relationship would go. That's kind of my belief on it, and mostly everyone on the planet does not agree with this kind of idea. I don't know why, but I don't. It's not my business. Everyone, to each their own on that front. That's a perfect example of kind of what I'm talking about. I don't know. As far as, like, personal life, going back to the whole personal life thing. Excuse me. Jeez. As far as going back to the personal life thing goes, granted, there has a lot been going on, but I guess in the words of Jimmy Eat World, anybody who's my age should know this reference, or older, take some time. I'm in the middle of a ride. Yeah, I'm skipping some words I know. Technically, the lyrical goes, take some time, little girl, you're in the middle of the ride. But first of all, I'm not a girl. I'm pretty sure. But secondly, I was more using it for reference anyway. But anyway, I'm going to end and leave this video here. I've been rambling for 23-ish minutes now, 24 almost. But thank you guys for tuning into this little Dave Speaks His Mind video, I guess, is what we're going to start calling this series. I may just do it like I've done some of the other videos, where it's just Dave Speaks His Mind, number 1, 2, 3, 4, and move from there without any kind of super or subtitle. I know a lot of the time I do super titles. For those of you who don't know the difference, a super title is a title of an episode that the episode description title comes first, whereas a subtitle, it comes after. Anyway, yeah, gonna leave this here. Thanks for tuning in to the video, guys. If you liked it, make sure to give the video a like. And I don't know, if you like these kind of vlogs, why not consider subbing to the channel? I plan on doing these for, I'm gonna try to consistently do these every day, like I have been for the past couple of years now. But why not click the link on this side of my head if you want to check out the rest of the playlist that this is connected to. Unless you're watching this when it first comes out, then it'll be a random video. Or click the link on this side where you might find another random video. Well, this side will probably end up being a video that is recent, whereas this side will probably be a video that you may enjoy whether you like this one or not. I don't know. If you're still here, you probably like this video. Anyway, yeah. Thanks again for tuning in, guys, and I'll see all of you later. Bye.